City issuing a stark warning, the bank disclosing billions in one-time charges and reserves to investors ahead of its earnings report tomorrow on Friday.
UPS joins several high-profile companies that have recently announced layoffs, among them Xerox, Wayfair, and Amazon.
As interest rates climb to a 22-year high and the specter of a looming economic crisis grows more tangible, Citigroup's recent warning to investors serves as a stark reminder of the precarious state of global financial markets. Despite earlier optimism, Federal Reserve Chairman Powell's unwavering commitment to raising rates has sent shockwaves through various sectors, leading to significant job losses and economic turbulence. With banks like Citigroup announcing massive layoffs and bleak financial results, the urgency of the situation cannot be overstated. In 2022, Powell embarked on a candid mission, warning the nation of the impending pain wrought by his decision to raise interest rates and implement quantitative tightening. However, Wall Street and other stakeholders failed to grasp the gravity of his message. Many dismissed Powell's declarations as mere bluster, betting that he would eventually relent and reverse course. Initially, Powell's policies sent shockwaves through the stock market, causing a plunge in stock prices. Yet as time passed, investors regained confidence, believing they had weathered the storm. Unfortunately, their optimism proved misplaced, perhaps serving as the catalyst for Powell's unyielding stance. At the heart of Powell's thesis lay a simple yet sobering truth. As the economy contracts, so too do job opportunities. With dwindling livelihoods, consumer spending wanes, triggering a domino effect that exacerbates economic downturns. Consequently, the Federal Reserve hiked interest rates a staggering 11 times, propelling figures to a 22-year pinnacle. For instance, the surge in interest rates significantly impacted the housing market. Homebuyers, once eager to outbid each other, now face the harsh reality of inflated mortgage rates. Consequently, families found themselves walking away from once desired properties, unable to bear the burden of increased monthly payments. The repercussions rippled across various sectors, particularly affecting professionals in architecture, real estate, construction, and other blue-collar fields. Powell's foresight was unwavering as he forewarned of the inevitable wave of job losses. Fast forward 2 years, and his predictions have materialized, with hundreds of thousands of employees already laid off, and more layoffs looming on the horizon. Recently, Citigroup made headlines with its announcement to downsize its workforce by a staggering 20,000 employees, representing approximately 10% of its total staff, over the next 2 years. The decision comes on the heels of the bank's dismal quarterly financial results, with losses totaling $1.8 billion in the fourth quarter of 2023 and a 3% decline in revenue compared to the previous year. As Citigroup issues its cautionary note to investors, there's a palpable sense of apprehension regarding the Federal Reserve's next moves. While optimism persists for imminent rate cuts, there's a growing possibility that the Fed may prolong higher rates, bucking expectations of an easing trend. In analyzing historical parallels, Citigroup economists draw attention to the late 1990s, where rapid rate cuts preempted a looming financial crisis. However, the subsequent cycle of rate increases aimed to curb inflationary pressures underscores the complexity of monetary policy decisions amidst economic turbulence. In January, the U.S. labor market showcased robust growth, exceeding expectations and reinforcing its solidity as a pillar for broader economic expansion. Non-farm payrolls surged by an impressive 353,000, surpassing the Dow Jones estimate of 185,000, according to the latest report from the Labor Department's Bureau of Labor Statistics. The unemployment rate remained steady at 3.7%, defying projections of a slight uptick to 3.8%. Across various sectors, job creation was widespread, with professional and business services leading the pack with 74,000 new jobs. Healthcare, 70,000. Retail trade, 45,000. Government, 36,000. Social assistance, 30,000. And manufacturing, 23,000. Also made significant contributions to the overall employment landscape. Daniel Zhao, lead economist at Glassdoor, remarked, "This just reaffirms that the jobs market is entering 2024 on solid ground," underscoring the optimism surrounding the labor market's resilience. George Mateo, chief investment officer at Key Private Bank, characterized the job report as a blowout, echoing sentiments of confidence in the economy. He emphasized that strong job gains, coupled with faster than expected wage growth, could prompt a delay in anticipated interest rate cuts for the year, prompting market participants to reassess their expectations. However, amidst the positive job growth figures, an important inflation indicator suggests a moderation in price increases as 2023 drew to a close. The Commerce Department's Personal Consumption Expenditures Price Index for December rose by a modest 0.2% for the month and 2.9% on a yearly basis, excluding food and energy. While economists had anticipated slightly higher increases, the data indicates a downward trend in inflationary pressures. Core inflation saw a slight uptick from November, but the annual rate saw a decline from previous months, reaching its lowest point since March 2021. Headline inflation, inclusive of food and energy costs, remained steady at 2.6% annually, indicating a stabilization in overall price levels. These developments bolster the argument that while inflation remains elevated, it is gradually trending lower, potentially paving the way for the Federal Reserve to consider interest rate cuts later in the year. Joseph Bruzuelas, chief economist at RSM, highlighted that inflation dynamics align with the Fed's policy objectives, suggesting a forthcoming adjustment in the central bank's stance. Beyond the statistical analysis, the reality for many Americans is one of grappling with inflationary pressures and high interest rates, underscoring the broader economic challenges facing households across the nation. Americans are increasingly reliant on their credit cards, with total card balances reaching a new record of $1.08 trillion, as reported in the latest quarterly update from the Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Ted Rossman, senior industry analyst at Bankrate, highlighted that over the past 2 years, Americans' credit card debt has surged by a staggering 40%. The report also revealed that nearly half, or 49% of cardholders, carry credit card debt from month to month on at least one card, marking an increase from 46% in the previous year. Furthermore, an alarming 56 million cardholders have been in debt for at least a year. The burden of debt extends beyond credit cards, as American households accumulated a record $17.29 trillion in debt last year, driven by mortgage, credit card, and student loan balances, according to the latest data from the Federal Reserve Bank of New York. Recent data indicates a concerning trend of consumers falling behind on their payments, with 29.6% of Americans in the 100 largest metros experiencing delinquencies between July 1st and September 30th, 2023. Of these, 27.3% have debts seriously overdue by 90 days or more, while 26.2% have debts in collections. The impact of rising prices and higher interest rates exacerbates the financial strain on Americans. As prices have soared in recent years, the average American's budget faces significant pressure, with limited room for flexibility. Higher interest rates further compound the challenge, shrinking people's financial margin for error even further. Inflation at the wholesale level surged unexpectedly in January, according to the Labor Department's Producer Price Index, which rose by 0.3% from the previous month and 0.9% annually, exceeding economist predictions. Core prices, excluding food and energy, also experienced a sharp increase of 0.5% for the month and 2% annually, surpassing estimates. These inflationary pressures are evident in the Consumer Price Index, which rose by 0.3% in January from the previous month and 3.1% from the same time last year, outpacing economists' forecasts. Both the Producer Price Index and Consumer Price Index are critical indicators of inflationary pressures, with inflation levels remaining above the Federal Reserve's preferred target of 2%. In the backdrop of all of these issues, even weightier matters have been addressed. Following Jamie Dimon's cautionary note regarding a potential market rebellion against the $34 trillion national debt, Federal Reserve Chair Jerome Powell has emphasized the urgency of engaging in a mature discourse about the unsustainable trajectory of fiscal policy. Powell's remarks came during an interview on CBS's 60 Minutes, where he underscored the long-term ramifications of the escalating national debt. In the long run, the U.S. is on an unsustainable fiscal path, Powell cautioned, shedding light on the gravity of the situation. Despite the U.S. economy's resilience in sidestepping a widely anticipated recession in 2023, soaring government expenditures and dwindling tax revenues have propelled the national debt to unprecedented heights. This trend has persisted into the current year, with the U.S. government debt-to-GDP ratio surging from just over 100% in 2019 to over 120%. While this figure marks a decline from the COVID-era peak of 133%, Powell emphasized that the government's debt continues to outpace economic growth. In light of these concerning developments, Powell stressed the imperative of initiating an earnest dialogue among elected officials to steer the federal government towards a sustainable fiscal trajectory. He asserted, "It's now past time to get back to an adult conversation about getting the federal government back on a sustainable fiscal path," underlining the necessity for proactive measures to address the mounting debt burden. Despite mounting criticism, Treasury Secretary Janet Yellen has downplayed concerns surrounding the rising national debt. Yellen has cited net interest payments as a share of GDP as a key metric, maintaining that it remains at a very reasonable level, despite the escalating debt levels. Meanwhile, even as the government continues to sell narratives of optimism concerning the economy, there are telltale signs that there's trouble in paradise. Since 2002, Jeff Bezos, the founder of Amazon, has divested more than $30 billion in shares, with approximately $20 billion sold in 2020 and 2021 alone. Recent reports indicate that he has further liquidated his Amazon holdings, bringing the total value of sales to over $4 billion. The question arises, why is the third richest individual in the world selling off his shares at such a rapid pace? It suggests that Bezos may possess insights or knowledge that eludes the general populace. Meanwhile, against the backdrop of soaring interest rates, the commercial real estate sector is experiencing significant upheaval. With U.S. banks holding approximately $2.7 trillion in commercial real estate loans, the majority managed by smaller regional banks, concerns abound regarding their resilience in the face of impending challenges. Rising interest rates are eroding the value of bank assets, particularly government bonds, leaving financial institutions vulnerable to potential bank runs. Despite potential interest rate reductions by the Federal Reserve, the commercial property crisis remains in its nascent stage and exhibits no signs of abating. The current proportion of delinquent loans reported by banks pales in comparison to the anticipated surge in defaults projected for 2024 and 2025. Consequently, banks remain exposed to significant risks, and any prospective interest rate cuts in the upcoming year are unlikely to mitigate the underlying issues confronting financial institutions. Simply put, a crisis is underway. In the face of these mounting economic hardships and alarming market indicators, it's clear that the U.S. is entering a period of heightened economic instability.